Third graders, our Under the Sea collage is going to start with some fish drawings. So you're going to have a smaller piece of tag board and a larger, and there's lots of pictures of fish around the room for you to look at just to get some ideas. You don't have to copy them perfectly. They're just to kind of help you get a start. When you're looking at the fish, I would look for shapes. So I'm going to zoom in and draw this fish right here and just kind of explain what I look at when I start a drawing. I'm kind of looking at his body as this large oval. You could draw the whole oval, or maybe just the top and the bottom is what I'm going to draw, so I don't have to erase as much. Erasing's not a bad thing. I'm just feeling a little bit lazy. Where his mouth is, it kind of looks like the letter V to the side. And then I would kind of connect those. Now, it's not exactly like that, but it works. It's looking like a fish mouth. His tail looks like a rounded square on the end. I'm gonna kind of have it come out a little bit. And then instead of a straight edge, I'm just gonna curve those sides. The top again looks like a letter U or half of an oval at the top. I'm gonna start that. It does have a few spikes. You could add those if you wanted. And on the bottom, again, his fins are very curved coming from that back tail. And then he's got a really long part of his fin. I'm gonna run out of room on my paper. I'm just gonna make it a little smaller. When I look at his eye, I'm not gonna worry about all the stripes. I'm gonna get his eye in there, just a very circle shape with another circle in the middle. He does have a line that kind of separates his head, and that'd be more where his gill is. And now I'm seeing this fin does come up and touch that. So I could add that, maybe do a little erasing. Pretty simple pencil line drawings. Big fish, small fish, they can be the same or different. Then we're gonna use those oil crayons and color them. And when you're coloring, I just want you to think about mixing and blending. So these work awesome when you press hard to fill in those shapes. And then on top of that, I could blend a second color. Let's see what this pink color would look like. So if I go right on top, they start to make a new color. If you even want to smear with your finger, you can. You can even add texture or lines on top of this in another color. So as you're working on your fish, coloring them, drawing them, cutting them out, you are going to get called to the back counter to print. At the back counter, we're just going to make our water, and we're gonna add a couple circle prints. So I'm dipping this cup in the white paint. This is just kind of look like bubbles. You could do a couple, you can overlap, you can fill your paper. I think once you get the paint, one, two, you could maybe even do three prints, and then you're gonna need to get more. They don't have to be perfect circles. They could look like they're popping. I'm filling this whole paper up. Once you're done printing, you're gonna carry this paper back to your table spot and finish your fish. As you're working on your fish, you are also going to get your picture that I took and some snorkels and goggles. So fish, paper, lots of different things. With your snorkels and your goggles, carefully cut between the shapes so that someone else can use the items on this paper. I'm gonna scoot this printed paper to the side. All right, now that I have that out, I can cut a little bit more carefully. Your snorkel and your goggles don't have to be the same color. If you want them to be, they can. Remember to problem solve, cutting that middle piece out. Fold it in half, make a little cut. And then once you do that, you can open it up, get that bottom blade of the scissors in there. My scissors is upside down in my hand. And then I can follow that inside shape. So today you are drawing fish, coloring fish, cutting them out. You should have two. You're printing bubbles all over that blue paper. And you should have time today to find snorkels and goggles. If you get so far that you are ready to cut things out, you're going to cut your fish, cut your picture of yourself, and cut goggles and snorkels. All right, I have everything ready to put together. myself, cut out really nice around my head. And if you have a little bit of white at the bottom of the picture, make sure you cut that off as well. Two fish and the goggles and the snorkel. First thing I'm gonna glue is the picture of myself. As I'm gluing, I wanna make sure that I put this picture all the way touching the bottom of the paper. So if I put it right here, it's gonna look like I'm kind of chopped off. If I slide it to the bottom, it's gonna look like I'm in the foreground, like I'm the closest to the picture right now. All right, my paper is a little bit wet yet from my printing, but I'm ready to add goggles. Just a little line of glue around that backside. I wanna try to see my eyes in those goggles. The snorkel shouldn't, well, it could cover your goggles, but it should touch your mouth. In your picture, your mouth should be closed, like you actually have that snorkel around your lips. And then it can overlap or it can go to the side by itself. The fish, we are gonna glue them so it looks like they're kind of in front of ourselves. So now the fish have become the foreground. You will find some little pieces of foam. I'm gonna put a dot of glue, and you can see I use these fish already. I'm gonna place two on each fish, and that's gonna kind of pop it up a little bit so you can actually put them in front of yourself. They could be looking up or going up above your head. Your fish could even overlap if you wanted a fish behind it, or your fish could be in front of you. I wouldn't cover up your face entirely, or we're not gonna know it's you, but have some fun placing those fish in some spots. Last step, if you so choose to, you can add some ground or seaweed coming from the bottom of your paper. It really doesn't matter what color you use for this. The bottom of the ocean floor would have blues and greens. It might have pinks. It might have corally purple colors. You can draw on top of your picture. You can draw on the sides of your picture. I would not draw all over your face because your family is gonna wanna try to find you on open house night. When everything is complete, it's gonna go in the drying rack.